Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 22nd of May. PM Modi dismisses opposition's 79-seat claim in UP. Rahul Gandhi promises debt relief to farmers. Bangladesh minister claims missing lawmaker murdered in India. And Sri Lanka rejects Canadian PM Trudeau's genocide claims during civil war. And now for all the details. Taking a jibe at opposition leaders Rahul Gandhi and Akhilesh Yadav's claim of winning 79 Lok Sabha seat in UP, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday said that people will wake up from their dreams on 4th of June when results will be announced. The Prime Minister, during a rally in Basti, said they won't be able to tolerate their defeat and will later on blame the electronic voting machine. PM Modi also called Congress and Samajwadi Party sympathizers of Pakistan and alleged that they are scaring the country with its nuclear power status.
ये दोनों सहजादे अब मिलकर अफवाह उड़ा रहे हैं. ये कहते हैं यूपी की 79 सीट जीत जाएंगे. मैं पहले सुना करता था कि लोग दिन में सपने देखते हैं. मुझे अब पता चला दिन में सपना देखने का मतलब क्या होता है. चार जून को यूपी की जनता इनको नींद से जगाने वाली है और तब ये ठिकरा EVM पर फोड़ेंगे.
However, Rahul Gandhi, while campaigning in Haryana, said that India bloc will get rid of farmers' debt if it comes to power. Mentioning about the repeal of farm laws after protest, Rahul Gandhi said PM Modi had to back out after farmers of Haryana, Punjab, Karnataka and Kerala took to streets. PM Modi is widely expected to win a rare third time in the general elections that will conclude on 1st of June, with votes set to be counted on June 4th. Meanwhile, India is wilting under scorching heat as temperatures hit record high, affecting health and livelihoods. Residents in a slum area of India's capital, New Delhi, clamoured for water as temperature in the city continued to scorch. A spell of extreme heat has dried up water reservoirs and spiked the need for water, with three tankers arriving each day at Delhi's Vivekanand Camp slum area. The weather department has issued a red alert for heat wave this week in Delhi, indicating the likelihood of temperatures that can cause heat-related illnesses for those exposed. Similarly, in Pakistan, people were seen struggling with soaring temperatures amid heat wave conditions. An advisory warned that the soaring heat would be felt in most parts of the country, especially Punjab and Sindh, with a severe heat wave expected from May 23 to 27. Over the past decade, extreme hot weather in South Asia has become increasingly frequent. And days after Bangladesh lawmaker Muhammad Anwarul Azim went missing in India's Kolkata, Bangladesh Home Minister Asad Uzzaman Khan on Wednesday claimed he has been killed. In a press conference, the minister said, while joint investigation between Kolkata police and Bangladesh police is underway, arrests have also been made by Bangladeshi officials based on inputs with their Indian counterparts in connection to this case. However, an official of the Bangladesh High Commission in India said, so far no authentic information have been received from New Delhi and added, motive behind the killing remains unclear. The officials said the family members of the MP were scheduled to arrive in India by Wednesday evening. Azim, a member of parliament from border state of Bangladesh, had arrived in India on 12th of May but went incommunicado after May 16th.
As our Honorable Home Minister has announced, so definitely I believe it may be happened, and we want to endorse it, but still now we don't have any authentic information from the government of India. So still now we will have to wait, but we apprehend that he may be killed or assassinated.
20 तारीख को हम लोग को MEA से एक लेटर मिला इस मैटर को देखने के लिए पश्चिम बंगाल सरकार को. 22 को आज हम लोग को एक इनपुट मिला है कि उनका मर्डर कर दिया गया है और उसके बाद हम लोगों ने ये जो फ्लैट है लोकेट किया है एंड वी आर ट्राइंग अवर लेवल बेस्ट कि इस केस को जितनी जल्दी से जल्दी हो सके डिटेक्ट किया जाए.
मूविंग ऑन. Residents of Khapalu in Pakistan-occupied Gilgit-Baltistan have flagged concern over water shortage in the region, which is causing distress, especially amid peak tourist season. A report.
Locals in Khapalu Valley of Pakistan-occupied Gilgit-Baltistan have raised concern over shortage of safe drinking water in the region, especially during peak tourism season. Khapalu is known for glacial streams and lakes. But despite that, residents face water scarcity due to unavailability of proper supply system. A member of the GB Assembly flagged that solarization is the only solution, but the project has not been completed due to tenders not being passed.
और दिन ब दिन जो है पानी का जो मसला है वो खपलू में बिगड़ते जा रहे हैं और लोगों के लिए मसाइल है. टूरिस्ट का फ्लो जो है वो शुरू हो चुका है लेकिन होटलों में पीने का पानी नहीं है और बहुत सारी मसाइल जो है ना वाटर सप्लाई के हवाले से बढ़ रहे हैं. मनसूख करके दोबारा टेंडर करवाया जाए और एक काबिल अच्छे ठेकेदार को देकर जो है वहाँ पर यह सोलराइजेशन का काम, लिफ्ट का काम और बाकी जो है गांछे नाले में जो काम है उनको जल्द अज जल्द शुरू किया जाए. नहीं तो फिर ये स्कीम जो है ना वो रिवाइज करना पड़ेगा. आजकल रिवाइज का हम सबको पता है कि गवर्नमेंट के पास पैसा नहीं है.
रेजिडेंट्स ब्लेम दैट पाकिस्तान हैज बीन लूटिंग नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज ऑफ गिलगित बल्तिस्तान फॉर पास्ट 7 डेकेड्स बट हैज डिप्राइव्ड देम ऑफ इवन देयर बेसिक राइट्स. दे क्लेम द एजेंडा इज टू कीप द रीजन अंडर डेवलप्ड.
Sri Lanka on Tuesday hit out at Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau after he ragged up the Lankan civil war and levelled allegations of genocide against Colombo. Trudeau in a statement highlighted that Canada's parliamentary unanimously voted to recognise May 18 as Tamil Genocide Remembrance Day and added it continues to advocate for justice and accountability for the crimes committed during the conflict. Canada is a strong defender of human rights in Sri Lanka. And we continue to urge the government of Sri Lanka to respect freedom of religion, belief and pluralism, essential values to build lasting peace, he said. Rejecting Trudeau's remarks, Sri Lanka's foreign ministry said his endorsement of the false narrative of genocide in Sri Lanka is highly disruptive of communal harmony among the Lankan diaspora in Canada. In a statement, it said, all communities suffered in brutal terrorist acts of LTTE, which is a listed terrorist organization in 33 countries worldwide, including in Canada. Statements by the Prime Minister of Canada with regard to Sri Lanka are the outcome of electoral vote bank politics in Canada, funded by a small number of Canadians of Sri Lankan origin with vested and personal interest, it added. Colombo and Ottawa are often at loggerheads over the matter. Sri Lanka has repeatedly said such remarks by Canada are interference in internal matters of a sovereign country. And Kamirita Sherpa, a Nepali Sherpa guide, scaled the summit of Mount Everest for a record 30th time on Wednesday, an official said, while two climbers went missing while descending from the world's tallest peak. 54-year-old Kamirita had climbed the peak for the 29th time on 12th of May. He broke his own record, Kim Lal Gautam, chief of the Expedition Monitoring Field Office at the base camp, said. Ordinary climbers are known to take several days to climb the summit of Everest, and it's very rare for mountaineers to make multiple ascent in the short time. Kamirita first climbed Everest in 1994 and has done so almost every year since. Mountain climbing is a key tourism activity, source of revenue and an employment in Nepal. Home to 8 of the world's 14 highest peaks. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night and take care.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.